Welcome to another episode of Tinkerine Experiments. Today we are going to look into testing the buoyancy of PLA with different infill settings. This episode will be the first part of the experiment, and we will look into it further with a second experiment later. This was suggested by one of my colleagues, and here we are going to find out the buoyancy of PLA. I have 10 cubes here, with 0% infill all the way up to 90% infill. We'll slowly put in the cubes and find out whether or not they will float. I actually think all of them can potentially float since PLA is so light, but we'll find out. Let's start with the hollow cube. Yep, it is floating. Now 10% infill. It is still floating. Next is 20%. Now 30%. And then 40%. Oh, it looks like it is starting to sink more and more now. 50% is still floating. Let's move on to 60%. Now 70%. It's floating, but it's mostly submerged now. Next is 80%. Oh, it actually just sunk right in. I'm guessing 90% will sink as well. Yep. So from this test, we can confidently say that 0 to 70% infill will continue to float. So between 70% to 80% is where PLA becomes positive or negative buoyancy. This is a good measure to take into consideration if you are modeling something that needs to float in water. In the second part of the experiment, we will narrow down on the exact infill percentage. Well, there we have it. We found out the range regarding the infill percentage for PLA to remain floating, or a positive buoyancy. It is roughly 70% to 80%. In the next episode, we will look into narrowing down this number further. Before I end, I just want to remind everyone about Tinkerine U. The platform has a lot of teaching resources like 3D printing courses, STEAM challenges, and CAD tutorials. So be sure to check it out. That's the end of our experiment. If you liked our video, please give us a thumbs up, and if you did not, then a thumbs down below. Remember to subscribe and comment on what experiments you would like to see in the future. Thank you for watching. Tinker out.